Recipients of the first round of grants were selected through a lottery system by the Rhode Island Foundation. The fund has a budget of $750,000, which will be allocated in grants of $10,000 to Rhode Island nonprofits.
The managing director of Paragon Trust Company and tax and private client practitioner joins us to bring a common sense approach to money in a world of total insanity. Let's welcome Tony D'Angelo.
All right, our good pal Tony D joins us as he does each and every Tuesday. But before we actually bring Tony on, let's hit him with a little bit of this. Tony is always on top of the best tunes. The Racket Squad. I love it, Tony. What's going on, buddy? How are you?
Proud to be among everybody. Got to listen to the intro.
All right, let me let it go. Hold on.
What you're about to see is a real-life story. Taken from the files of the police racket and bunco squads, business protective associations, and similar sources all over the country. It is intended to expose the confidence game. The carefully worked out frauds by which confidence men take more money each year from the American public than all the bank robbers and thugs with their violence.
Ain't that a classic?
I love it.
And good morning, and proud to be among everybody. And it's a little bit of history. And when we talk about, some of the fun things we've been doing as far as where I get to talk about a movie or something like that, that's a classic show, Racket Squad. Or it was in the early 1950s talking about the confidence game. And I thought about it one day. And what we deal with today is pretty much the same thing as what's there. There's really nothing new under the sun. And when we talk about SMID and how, business is done in Connecticut, I made a comment on Twitter last week that was widely circulated, circulated to silence. I said the only real business going on in Connecticut is really funny business. And what I thought, and you and I had a discussion yesterday morning after the show about Pete from East Haven, and his call just touched my heart about, the ATVs and the dirt bikes and all the craziness. And you say to yourself, excuse me, when you have something like that and something so crazy, there's no real coverage anywhere. And, something like that really should be, in a sane world, would be the lead story on a 6 o'clock news. I mean, it's like, it's insane. What are we doing here? And you and I, Lee LC, have talked a lot about how, things that are just so obvious and things that are, with hard documentation, and they're either met with silence or they're met with, maybe a little damning with faint praise, but the only real thing that you really see happening is that you really begin to wonder, and where nothing really happens. And I was motivated to kind of look at this a little bit further, but I think I've got a couple of answers for this today as to why we get this, tunnel vision, or why poor Pete is getting assaulted by dirt bikes and nobody says anything, or why, Ned can pretty much run roughshod over everybody. And I'd like to deal with that. So we're going to move on. Now, I'm going to take us back to March of 2020, and which is really the onset of COVID-19. What do you think our state government was focused on at that point, or what would you think, or what did we think at the time? What was taking place and what the focus was?
Before COVID, is that what you're asking me?
Actually, right at the onset, probably at the first executive order of government, whatever, Ned's effective one-person rule, his executive authority. March of 2020, what do you think the focus was?
That's a great question. I mean, going into COVID, we talked about everything from unfunded liabilities to tolls, I guess.
But right at the moment, yeah. Right at the point of the crisis, where do you think Ned and his group was focused on?
I think
the crisis,
You would think.
But when you dig a little bit further, that's not really what's happening. as such. Now, I spent a little bit of time going through the DAS contract portal. Again, it's a mess. It's a joke. Not everything gets posted. They play dirty. They give you some stuff. They don't give you other stuff. In March of 2020, there is a decision made, and the decision made is we're going to go into the spin factory. Mm. And with the spin factory, we are going to actually fund, and this is right at the tip of the iceberg, $75 million of media contracts. $75 million. It's a 1,080-page contract. I've got it. And in this contract, there's like serial people that they're listing as to who is getting media money. I thought we were all at home. You know, I thought we were all supposed to be there. This terrible disease. I'm not mocking the disease, mind you. Any disease is bad.
Right.
But it's like $75 million is directed at media for the purposes. And why do you fund media companies? Well, you fund media companies for spin. You fund media companies so you can create kind of like a little Beijing thing happening here and really kind of have state-run media. And honestly, truthfully, where I get very, very angry, this is what we have here. We have a Chinese-style economy. We have, you know, where it's like, well, why can't we get news out? Well, what kind of glad-handing is going on between these media companies and the media outlets? Is there any way of finding out? Does anybody ever ask these questions? I mean, my Lord. I mean, $72 million in media contracts right at the onset of the pandemic.
I don't remember this. So that's why I couldn't answer that. I don't remember this at all. So is this something that was flying under the radar? Was this regular news? What media outlets received that money? Do you know? Does it have it listed?
Well, I mean, you really, we're going to start to take a look at that because you really can't, it will take hours to kind of go down and sort of play everybody through the maze. I'll tell you this much. There is one media outlet. We'll get into that a little bit next week. But of this whole $72 million, they received about $30.5 million. And the people that are in this media outlet are very heavily involved in, you know, my alma mater, Sacred Heart University. So when Ned has a great rating, hey, it ain't hard. It ain't hard. Why would you bite the hand that feeds you? And the thing is, this violates every single ethic of a fourth estate. You know, how could this not be?
Yeah, but
this is what you're doing at the top of a pandemic. You know, 72, so actually between 72 and 75. Again, it's 1,000 pages. You know, it's tough to go through every single thing in 10 minutes, but man, yeah. Oh, man.
I'm trying to, you know, go back into time. I mean, as I get older, my memory is not as great as it used to be. I forget, you know, what I had for breakfast that morning, but I know that a story like this would have popped. I don't remember this story at all. Like, I don't remember anybody covering this.
And well, yeah, because you're really kind of being paid not to give the story. That's my point.
I understand that, but you would think in the medium that we are in, and you know the people that I talk to and you talk to every single day, in particular, you know, when it comes to media access and things of that nature, I would have heard something about this. This is an incredible story to unleash on folks. If, you know, $70 million was funneled to media outlets to shut up, it's huge. Huge!
Well, it's an ostensible shut up. And this actually where, you know, you write your articles in the day and, you know, I'm blessed to come here during the weekend. Why is there silence? Well, put it this way. If you start to answer that, then you blow your cover. We're back to the rackets again. You know, you just keep doing as you're doing. Just keep, you know, putting the stuff out there. And, you know, hey, so what? People listening here. I mean, the great part about what you have done here, Lee Elsie, is you've provided a voice for, quote unquote, the voice of freedom and truth. These are things that are happening that you're not going to get anywhere else, frankly.
Well, I appreciate that.
And I will send you the contract, and anybody that wants it, they can have it. I mean, obviously, if I send it to you, they won't have the ignominy of coming and asking me.
No, that's fine.
One thing I do want to point out is in this $72, $75 million, $1.5 million goes to the CERC, which became Advanced CT. And we'll get into that a little bit next week. But Advanced CT was prominent in the news maybe about 2-3 weeks ago in you know, being the funnel for bringing in Philip Morris and bringing the funnel for bringing in ITT. And I had tore off on people because I said there's funny money involved, and the people from Hearst got very angry with me. How dare I say such a thing? But, you know, it's you got to grease the skids to get the wheels, you know, moving on the conveyor belt. And this is how business is done. Again, I will say this, though. I had a discussion with a prominent Republican, and I said, if you don't start dealing with, quote unquote, what is the economy in this state and having a business mind, which Republicans are supposed to do, man, we're just in for more of the same. I mean, you know, it's absolutely incredible.
Tony D'Angelo joins us each and every Tuesday at 6:35 to chat about a number of different things. He normally uncovers some stuff that a lot of times nobody's ever thought about or, you know, did much digging into. And he is our go-to guy to do all that. And this latest unleashed of information on the media could be huge, and we'll have to follow up on that. But also you can hear him every once in a while with his, you know, kind of 60 seconds worth of you. I find those things very interesting, and I play them every once in a while, and I'm happy that you're doing them, and we'll continue to play them.
But people like them, and if they don't like them, please tell me and I'll stop, but unfortunately I'm having fun doing them.
That's all that counts. That's all that counts. So, all right, so
I don't care if you don't want me. I'm yours.
All right, so at least for the next couple of days or week or so, you're going to send me that. I got to take a look at some of the names on that are listed on that media contract. I want to.
Yeah, it's. I mean, I think it explains, you know, going down to car thefts and poor Pete in East Haven and all the other. Like, why am I in Bizarro World? Well, I mean, you're pretty calculated here, you know, state of Connecticut. You know, who really? You know, Connecticut oftentimes has the standard for playing dirty. This is unbelievable. Mm. This was done under cloak of night. It does explain. You know, old ancient scripture. We have faith for what we hear, and if we keep hearing, that is wonderful, that is wonderful, that is wonderful, we're going to walk around saying, that is wonderful, that is wonderful. You know, it's, man, I really just want to see some just truth in advertising in the state.
All right, brother. Always a great job. Great talking to you, as always, on these Tuesdays, and keep them coming.
Yeah, pleasure to be among you, and pleasure to be among the kids.
All right, bud. I'll talk to you later. Tony D'Angelo. Every Tuesday, chatting with us and always opening up our eyes, some things that nobody knew about, he uncovers. All right, we'll be